last Saturday, Belen's life was taken senselessly by one of the young people in the community. And consequently, that tragedy has shaken the very foundation of our country and our state. And our hearts are out there. And today, I'm here with Sindi. Yesterday in the evening, I spoke to Sindi, and she said, I'm with you. We are on the same side. We want to see accountability. We want to see justice. And we want to see peace. We want to see unity in our community. When the incident happened, Sandy's daughter, 6 years old, was there with her grandmother. You can imagine why two of us are here today. Every time an incident happened, I would be one of the first people to get contact. And we are united, and we want to make sure that no other families should go through the same pain again. This is not about race or religion. We are here because if somebody out there in our community, and I'm talking about the Australian community, and they care and they are grieving and they want to see Belen's legacy shine on, you need to join us.
Yep.
You need to be with us because she was a leader in the community, a devoted Christian. She donated to many charities around the world, including in Africa, helping young people and poor communities. The best way we can honor her legacy is for us to preach peace, unity, justice, and accountability, and to make sure that people who do wrong things are held accountable individually. We are very lucky to be in this country. Very lucky because we do have institutions and systems that accommodate our cultural diversity. That's why we live in peace, relative peace. We have seen everywhere around the world countries where leaders and institutions have failed to accommodate their cultural diversity. And we cannot afford that here in Australia. Whatever the case, we need to work together. We need to send a message out there that hate has no place here. Racism has no place here.
Mum's legacy will live on in peace. One of her things, even with family fights, and not as normal families do, her thing was pursue peace with all diligence. And she was never one to be prejudiced. She was, you know, always look for the best in people. And I think the thing is, Benny has done an amazing job in the community. I've heard nothing but great stories from, like, everywhere. So, you know, I mean, people come to Australia. It's a land of opportunity. And my dad, coming from Malta, you know, we've got different nationalities in here. We've all come for a better life, you know, to provide for our families, to escape horrors of and unimaginable things. And I would hope that if Australia was the countries that suffer this, we could take refuge in another country and be safe and not be targeted because we're a different colour. Mum always said if I died, no one would care. And sorry, Mum, you've sort of got a bit of a spotlight now. And you know what? If this is for one reason only, it's to pursue peace. I don't care if you're having family squabbles, you haven't spoken to your mum or brother or sister or cousins or whatever for any reason. It's irrespective of colour, irrespective of race. Sort your crap out, because you don't know. You know, you might go into the shop and get some groceries. You don't know if they're ever going to come back. I don't want people living in fear of that, but I've always, because of the medical stuff I've had to go through, I'm like, live today as if it's the last day. Always be the best you can be. Tell your people you love them. Yeah. I have bad days. My daughter can tell you I'm not perfect. I'm far from perfect and I get cranky. But at the end of the day, everyone should know they're loved. Say the kind word to someone in the shop. You don't know them, but sometimes a kind word and kind gesture. You know, there's so many people in the community suffering depression and anxiety and everything else because of the stresses of life with, you know, things in the economy and everything else. You know, it's just, and now these people are scared to leave their homes, all colours. You know, like I spoke to someone, they said, my mum lives in Toowoomba and they, you know, going to the shop, they don't even want to go to the shop anymore. Like just grandmothers are scared to leave their house. People are up the local chemist and stuff. I'm like, they park underneath, you know? It's just like shopping centres are like literally getting emptier and emptier and shouldn't go there like and be scared to get your groceries.